In this video, I'm going to cover Nokia stock in terms of the double downward trend resistance lines dating back since 2000-2001. I'm going to cover what level it needs to pass in terms of the second resistance line, what level is going to be important for a pretty decent run-up in my opinion. And quick disclaimer before I continue, I'm not a financial advisor, I'm not a professional. Everything I do share with you is just my opinion, it is not advice, so please do your own due diligence and research before buying and selling. Also, I'm going to cover the downside a little bit as well in terms of support level. Now, we closed at $5.48 as of June 4th, 2021. Pre-market's around that ballpark, not necessarily looking great, but it's around that ballpark overall. And right now, in terms of, just in case you're a new viewer, by the way, in terms of downward trend resistance line, what I mean by is, for example, right about here, dating back from 2014 all the way till like just a bunch of touch points right here from 2017. So from 2014 to 2017, you can see a bunch of times it got knocked down. And yeah, there was a couple false breakouts like you see right here and here. But even when there was a false breakout, it had to pass the second resistance line where it has an issue. But when it did pass all of them, it did pretty well. Now, arguably there is more resistance obviously above the second resistance line. That's a given. But at least you'll have a decent run up in my opinion. It could have a false breakout, and that's I'll cover what levels it need to pass to technically take care of the false breakout. So stay tuned, I guess. But okay, so right now, like I've mentioned in the past videos, had to pass this first resistance line, had gone up on an upward trend support line, so it was looking great and just continued to the upside. It, honestly, awesome stuff, and did not get knocked down. It actually flew past it, so that was great stuff. Another issue that I was saying that potentially could have happened was could have gotten knocked down by the moving average like we saw right here and potentially here, and then there was another one right here. So I'm gonna zoom in, hopefully you could see in cleaner touch points. So here got knocked down by the moving average, this one as well. This one arguably is a false breakout, didn't necessarily get knocked down, but it did technically if you count false breakouts. Now what happened is gone past the first resistance level, downward trend resistance level. Not only that, went past the moving average and bounced off as support, so even more better stuff. And now we're here right now, disregard this line right now because that's more for detailed stuff here and there, and that's where we're at right now. Now we're trying to pass this downward trend resistance line right here. Now in order to do that, you're basically looking at around the $6 price point, the low $6 price point. This is the 5-year moving chart, or the 5-year chart. The problem is, I would say be careful about the $6 price point, because in terms of the 5-year chart, it compresses everything. I would say it's more of a better indication to pass the $6.65, give or take, given this horizontal resistance. So if you look horizontally right here, there's a bunch of times where it went up to 665. It might be around 670. You could enter early around the 650 price point if you wanted to, if you want to take a risk, more of a risk if you wanted to, but you could wait around 650, 665, 660 and all that stuff. But I'd say 670 would be a decent indication. But if you're willing to take the risk, around the 650, 660 range, 665 would be pretty decent. So passing those levels horizontally would be pretty fine right here. Now, the problem is the next level you're gonna probably get probably get crushed on is around the 730. But I'm anticipating potentially there's gonna be, so if you pass, so that takes care of the false breakout, right? So 670 is pretty decent, and you know you're in the upward trend support. And I'm gonna indicate the movements overall in terms of what movement indicates we're gonna continue to upside even more. But the 850 range, I believe, yeah, 830, 850 range right about here, or it goes up to 865, I guess. But 830 to 865, mainly 830, I would say personally, you can see it horizontal, just a bunch of times got knocked down. That could cause issue. Personally, I'm thinking it could probably consolidate around that. So let's just say visually, just to show visually, let's just say it goes up $6, getting knocked down, but then comes back up to test it or something, and then bounces off to support as well, has issues around the 670, like I stated, and then goes up to the 830 price point, right? If it doesn't pass it, hoping that it consolidates around the 830 that we saw around here. So 830, and then it comes down to, like, let's just say even 688, but most likely it's probably gonna come down to like 767, right? Around there, give or take. And hopefully breaks up to the upside if good news continues. Because if good news doesn't continue, then it'll just start coming back down, and this whole entire thing would just look like a false, not false breakout, but just be like around, almost like this, where it did break out to the upside, and then it comes back down. So if you're not optimistic for the company, then I guess around the $38.65 would be the price point that you would piece out on and then just come back at a later date when it comes down lower. But if you're optimistic, then you would start heading up higher and all stuff, and you would have technically nothing to worry about as long as you're doing your research and due diligence and keeping up with the stock and knowing what's happening and if it's still good or not good and all stuff. So hopefully that helps for the upside. In terms of more in-depth too as well, it was doing pretty well in terms of upward trend support, but it did break the upward trend support. So you can see it bounced off here and bounced off here, and it looked like it pre-bounced, actually got knocked down too as well. So right now it could have a little bit of turbulence for the meantime, but I'm not anticipating that for the most part. But in 1 month chart, MACD line is in the negative, so I guess it does confirm it. So it's gonna have issues. So I'm gonna cover the downside a little bit too as well. So in terms of the 1 month moving at or MACD line right now, this indicates if it's a bearish or bullish movement if you're new to the channel. So right now it's in the negative, it is bearish, so it's not optimistic. When it crosses over to a positive, it's bullish and it's optimistic. The only thing is, though, this is the 1 month chart, 3 month chart right here as well, so it's still negative. I want to show one thing. So the 1 year chart, yeah, so the 1 year chart is in the bullish movement. So this is more of the longer term. These are for the shorter term. I'm going to go over them as well, don't worry. But in terms of the longer term, right now it's optimistic, it's bullish, and it's good. And in terms of the 5 year chart, it's still optimistic, it's bullish, it's good as well. So right now, I don't see any slowdown. The bars are still not getting smaller, they're still full green, they're not lighter green. The line is not curving for the 5 year movement. Same with the 1 year chart. The 1 year chart bar is not getting smaller. It's not necessarily curving, but potentially could be curving, so be careful about that for the 1 year movement. But now if we go with the 3 year chart, 3 year chart broke the support. Essentially, even if you moved it right here, it got broken. Technically might get knocked down, but hopefully it doesn't get knocked down. And then MACD line, I don't see necessarily a full slowdown because it's not necessarily curving. Plus, it did get lighter shade of red, so that is potentially an indication of an upside. So maybe it could still go up a little bit. Keep in mind, this is just for short term. So short term, you might drop a little bit lower. And the lower levels you could drop down to, I'll cover in the 1 month chart, is right about here. So again, not necessarily fully slowing down. The bars are not really getting smaller. No real curve, but it could curve. But the support level you could rely on right now at the moment is around 536. And if it does get worse, I would say you could look at 517 or 520, somewhere between 517 to 520, maybe worst case around 514. So I don't think it's potential. It could potentially go down that low because you have a bunch of like touch points right about here. Like for example, if you look right about here, 516, plus it coincides with this moving average 520. So just to explain, this moving average, it could bounce off this moving average, go upside, or bounce off this moving average and go upside. Is that a guarantee? No, it's not a guarantee. But if you've been a viewer of my channel, and for example, you can see right here, came down to the moving average, bounced off to the upside as support. Again, not a guarantee you'll do that, but that is a potential. So hopefully you liked the video. Hopefully you found it helpful. If you did, consider dropping a like. It does help the channel. Thank you. Appreciate it. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to ask. I'll try to answer them as soon as possible. And if you like videos like this or other stock videos or other financial videos, consider subscribing. It does help out the channel, so thank you so much for that. I appreciate it. I hope you liked it overall, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks, Sam. Peace.